Hello, today we are going to study the draw of tube and the nozzle. We'll see the draw of nozzle first. This blue piece over here is a draw of nozzle. The yarn is taken from the rotor by the delivery shaft and the pressure roller. It is diverted almost at right angles by the draw of nozzle into the rotor through the draw of tube. So the yarn that is being taken by the delivery shaft over here, as you can see, it is diverted almost 90 degrees right angles by this draw of nozzle into the rotor, and this yarn is pulled through the draw of tube that can be seen here. The draw of nozzle creates the false twist effect and temporarily inserts additional twists up to 60% into the yarn, as the yarn continuously rolls off on the surface of the draw of nozzle due to the rotation of the rotor. Now the rotor is rotating continuously, and because of this, the yarn that is being inserted here is made to actually roll on the draw of nozzle, and because of this rolling effect, this nozzle would act like a false twister and would insert additional twist which are temporary in nature. The greater the false twist effect, the higher is the spinning tension. Let us see what the draw of nozzles are made up of. They are either made up of ceramic steel or ceramic and steel. In the case of the third type, where ceramic and steel both are used, the nozzle head is made up of ceramic and the holder is made up of metal. Solid ceramic holders are wear resistant and exhibit very low heat dissipation. Therefore, they are not suited for man-made fibers. For man-made fibers, we'll have to go for metallic nozzles due to their good heat dissipation property. But they have a short life, and therefore they are used in processing only very temperature sensitive man-made fibers with very low melting and softening points. Processing of cotton with high mineral sand content and man-made fibers containing too much delustrant agent like titanium dioxide, because of their wear properties, they reduce the life of the ceramic nozzle. The service life of a ceramic nozzle is between 10,000 hours for polyester and 20,000 hours when a cotton is being processed. So let us come to the positioning of the top edge of the nozzle. Now, as you can see in the diagram here, this is the rotor and this is the nozzle head that is there. Now we can adjust the distance that this nozzle goes into the rotor cup here. This distance I can adjust. So positioning of the top edge of the nozzle relative the rotor groove is important. In what way it helps, let us see. Normally the draw of nozzle protrudes far enough into the rotor cup for the yarn to be diverted almost at 90 degrees or at right angles at the draw of nozzle. So it is protruded or enough into the rotor cup just enough so that the yarn, you can see here, it is almost at 90 degrees to the rotor groove. So here this diagram is shown just to see the binding in the region. This is known as a twist zone or the binding in the region, where the yarn, where the twist in the yarn propagates in the rotor groove up to some distance, and this distance is known as a twist zone. The further the draw of nozzle protrudes into the rotor, that means the distance, if you keep closing and if it starts protruding more and more into the rotor, we can see that the angle of wrap that this will give, the yarn will give at the nozzle, will go on increasing. And more this angle goes on increasing, more is the false twist effect that is given by the nozzle, and longer will be the binding in zone in the rotor groove. So accordingly, this binding in zone will also increase as soon as you reduce this distance, or rather when the nozzle is more protruding into the rotor cup. and because of this longer binding in zone, we see that the yarn tenacity during spinning has increased. The position of the draw of nozzle relative to the rotor groove can be changed by using washers of different thicknesses. So if you use washers, then this distance can be reduced. Removing the washers reduces the false twist effect, resulting in a shorter binding zone and therefore reducing the tenacity during spinning. So as soon as you reduce the washer, this will protrude less into the rotor cup, and you see the effect, that the final effect is it reduces the tenacity during spinning and therefore the spinning stability. Let us come to the rotor surface. There are different types of rotor surfaces that are offered. So what are the changes that you see in the yarn by using different rotor surfaces or the nozzle surfaces, sorry. While rolling on the surface of the nozzle, the yarn is repeatedly raised briefly in rapid succession depending on the nozzle surface texture. So whether this surface is rough or smooth, depending on that, the yarn will be raised in frequently from the nozzle surface. The high frequency vibration along with the false twist effect, which this nozzle will provides, that we have just seen in the previous slide, promotes twist propagation into the rotor groove. The more pronounced the texture of the nozzle surface, the more vigorously the yarn vibrates, propagating the false twist into the rotor groove. So more the texture on a nozzle surface, we see that more is the false twist effect. Greater the false twist effect, lower is the true twist that needs to be inserted, and we can get a softer, bulkier yarn in this case. So if we want a softer and a bulkier yarn, we need to use a more rougher kind of a surface of the nozzle. Also, the spinning stability improves with the increasing false twist effect. So let us see the various types of nozzles that are available. Smooth and spiral ceramic nozzle. The rotor groove influences the bulk of the yarn produced, that we have seen in the earlier lecture, while the nozzle surface influences the surface texture and the hairiness. This is the smooth ceramic type nozzle. You do not see any rough surfaces on the face of it. So this kind of a nozzle will allow very low level of false twist to be propagated into the binding in zone, because it does not help raising the yarn from the nozzle surface that frequently. Therefore, to maintain the spinning stability, you need to insert high true twist level, and is to be inserted, and this type of nozzle is therefore rarely used. It produces a smooth warp yarn with low hairiness. So let us see the next type of nozzle, which is the spiral nozzle. Spiral nozzles are more suited for fine and compact 100% cotton yarns with low hairiness, and it provides quite high spinning stability. We come to the next type of nozzles, where there are notches, three notches you can see over here, or four or eight or even six. Nozzles with notches are universally applicable for cotton, man-made and their blends. Nozzles with four notches are suitable for warp and weft yarns. Nozzle with four to eight is suitable for knitting yarns, depending on the requirement for hairiness. What we see here, as we keep on increasing the number of notches over here, it helps in creating of more amount of false twist effect into the rotor region and the binding in region. And because of that, we can go for a lower true twist into the yarn, and we can spin softer yarns which are suitable for knitting. And if also it more the roughness on the nozzle surface, it will lead to more amount of hairiness. So depending on the requirement of the hairiness of knitting yarns, we can go for either 3 or 4 or 6 or 8 notches. Notched nozzles offer a high spinning stability. More the notches, more is the false twist effect, and higher is the hairiness and the ability to produce fly in the downstream process. Higher amount of hairiness will definitely lead to production or generation of fly in the processes that will follow. Then there are there's this type of nozzle where it is knurled with additional notches. As you can see, there are many notches over here. So this type of a nozzle is used for manufacturing of extremely hairy, very bulky and soft twist yarns. So now we come to draw off nozzles with a smaller radius as compared to the normal radius. This is the normal radius that is shown, and what we see is this is the yarn which is shown here, and we can see that the contact area over here with the yarn, with the yarn with the nozzle is quite high. Whereas the moment you decrease this radius, you can see this radius has been decreased, nozzle radius. And with a smaller radius, you see that the contact area has reduced. So, but natural, as soon as the there's a smaller area of contact in the smaller radius, the effect of false twist will be reduced, and therefore it will be more suited for processing polyester fibers, which will require to be run at higher rotor speeds. And therefore, the smaller radius ceramic draw off nozzles is more suited for polyester and its blends. And as you can see, the rotor speeds can be run now at 15% higher speeds. Now we come to draw off tubes through which the yarn is going to be taken up by the delivery shaft. So this is a normal draw off tube without twist stop. Twist stop is an element that is additional element which we will see in the next slide. The draw off tube that is used to guide the yarn on its removal from the spinning box, it looks like this. And as you can observe, there is a slight bend over here in the draw off tube. The draw off tube is bent at an angle of 30 to 60 degrees. The bend in the draw off tube that is there, it helps in the twist retention of the twist that is generated by the draw off nozzle in the rotor itself. So it doesn't allow the twist to flow further beyond the bend towards the delivery shaft. So as you can see in the diagram also, there is more amount of twist between the bend and the region right up to the rotor groove. So this kind of a bend helps in retention of the twist, which is a requirement. So greater the angle of bend, greater is the twist retention. So when the twist is retained more in the rotor groove region, you see that the spinning stability has increased. So there is one more element which is known as a twist stop, which can be inserted in the draw off tube near the bend, which will help in more retention of the twist in this region. So as you can see, this B is the twist stop or the torque stop. The twist retention effect can be increased by using a ceramic twist retention element known as a twist stop or the torque stop, which is shown in B above. The intensity may be changed by changing the area of contact in the radius of the bend. So if we were to increase the area of contact here, so we can increase the twist retention in this particular region. Because this particular element will not allow the twist to flow beyond this, or rather allow less twist to pass on or flow further towards the delivery shaft. So higher the friction caused by these inserts, greater is the twist retention. More intensive is the twist propagation into the groove, which leads to a higher spinning stability. Soft twisted knitting yarns can therefore be produced using when I say soft twisted, it means I'm using a low twist multiplier, and I can produce soft twisted yarns for knitting without actually adversely affecting the spinning stability. So if I want to go for soft twisted yarns without affecting spinning stability over here, I need to have a twist stop element in the draw off tube. The twist stops are designed as clips. These are small clips and which can be easily replaced. The design ranges from smooth type to having three grooves in the radius of the bend. So more the number of grooves here, more will be the area of contact in the radius of the bend, and more will be the twist retention in that case. And the moment you increase the twist retention, you tend to have a higher spinning stability because of the more twist propagation into the groove. So we come to the concluding slide here. So therefore, we see that a well-coordinated draw of nozzle and a draw of tube achieves the best results in terms of yarn quality, yarn texture in terms of hairiness, and the spinning stability. So here we come to the end of this lecture. Thank you.